Hey everybody, this video is just going to look at a multi-winding transformer. We're going to look at what some of the nameplate values are referring to. And then in an upcoming video, I will do one where I wire the windings in series based on a couple of parameters, and then I'll do another one based on a parallel connection with a couple of parameters and how that changes. But for this one, we're just going to look at some of these nameplate values and what they're actually referring to. So on the nameplate of my transformer, I look at the transformer says it is a 10 kVA transformer. Well, if we ignore all the losses of a transformer, we know that VA in equals VA out. Fancy way of saying the VA rating of the primary side is identical to the VA rating on the secondary side. What that's going to allow us to do is the volts per turn is consistent, the voltage ratio, the current ratio, all of those things stay true. That's why this will work all of the time. And the energy has to be converted. So if we think about it like that, the energy that exists on the primary side will be the same amount of energy that exists on the secondary side. That has to be true. Energy in has to equal energy out. Kirchhoff's current law, Kirchhoff's voltage law, all of those things still have to work. So some of the ratings that this will have, we have to know, well, I've got four different voltages. Where do those all go? So just for this example, I'm going to label this as my H1. Kind of an ANSI standard is that the H1 will always be the upper left. That way, if your terminals were missing, you would know that's definitively the H1. I could use an ohmmeter, but also if this is my H1, the other side of that winding has to be H2. So then if that's the other side of this winding, this will be H3. Here is my H4. Now, what the secondary side, or sorry, not the secondary side, what the other side of my transformer, the X side of my transformer, is going to be labeled is, if it is a additive or subtractive connection, will depend on where that X1 winding actually is. So let's put the X1 winding here. The other side of this winding has to be X2. We will have X3 and X4. So if I was to look at the terminal identification on that transformer, this is what I will identify. Well, another standard that's been established is that the H side of my transformer, step up, step down, doesn't matter. The H side will always be my high voltage side. If the H is my high voltage side, that means the X is always going to be my low voltage side. So now when we look at these values, I can look at high voltage to low voltage, and where do those actually come into play? So when I look at this multi-winding transformer with multiple voltages, this first value will always be the rating of one of the windings on one side. So if we follow that along, that means this H1, H2 winding, so H1 to H2, this winding itself will have a 120 volt rating. The H1 to H2 winding, this winding has to be exactly the same as this winding to make this transformer operate the way that it should. So if this is 120 volt rating, this winding will have a 120 volt rating. And now I have the option to wire it in series or parallel, and we'll get into that next. So if that has 120 volts, this has 120 volts. My entire H side is good for 10 kVA. That means each winding will share that VA. So this, just this one winding will have a 5 kVA rating, and this will be a 5 kVA rating for this winding. Now it doesn't matter. If I wire them in series, 5 plus 5 is still 10. If I wire them in parallel, 5 kVA plus 5 kVA is still 10 kVA. Everything is still true. Secondary side, we're going to follow that exact same principle. This lower voltage on that multiple rating is going to be the rating of one of these voltage, or one of these windings, sorry. So this one winding will have a 12 volt rating. This winding is going to be physically identical, electrically identical. So this will have a 12 volt rating. I can have a choice. I can wire these in series. I can wire them in parallel. Doesn't matter. If VA in equals VA out, I have 10 kVA on this side. I have to have 10 kVA on the secondary side. So then this one winding would share that VA rating for the X side. So here's 5 kVA, my 5 kVA. And then I could do some basic calculations to determine, well, what can this one winding handle? What can this one winding handle as far as current, as far as the load that I'm actually going to connect? So H1 to H2, these would be its ratings. H3 to H4, this would just be the one rating, or the rating of that one winding. So I hope this has helped, just to look at individual windings, how I can relate that nameplate value to one winding. We'll see you in the next one.